All Maulvis together, you can't paint all the people with the same brush. I don't know which Maulvi you are referring to, but coming to the first part of the question, that some people say that journalism involves ghibat. Sister, journalism is of various types. You have genuine journalism, yellow journalism, where you simply malign people. You have journalism which is good, and you have to follow the basic guidelines of the Quran, which says in Surah Isra, chapter 17, verse 81, وَقُلْ جَعَ الْحَقُّ وَزَاقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوكًا. When truth is heard against falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood is by its nature bound to perish. So if you are doing journalism, see to it that you always speak the truth. I do know the Quran says ghibat is wrong in Surah Humaza, chapter 104, verse number 1. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. Woe to every kind of scandalmonger and backbiter. The Quran says in Surah Hujurat, chapter 49, verse number 11 and 12, that do not backbite. If you backbite, it's as though you're eating the meat of a dead brother. I do know backbiting is wrong. So in journalism, you don't have to backbite, sister. And one more thing is there, that what is made public, suppose a person does something evil, and if you warn the people that this person is a bad person, that's not called a backbiting. If you call a backbiting, I would say that type of backbiting is allowed in Islam. Where if you're warning someone, for example, the Hadith of beloved Prophet which says that if somebody comes to ask you that you want to marry so and so person, and you know the background of that person, you say, no, that boy is not good, he has alcohol. If that's called backbiting, that type is allowed. Because they're warning the persons against certain harm. So if you're warning the people of the Ummah against certain harm of certain person, this type is allowed in Islam. So in journalism, if it's the truth and you warn the people against some calamity, against certain evil, Islam gives you permission. But don't write wrong things just to earn money. So that article will sell and you speak against someone so that that person gets a vote or somebody gives you money. 10,000 rupees, okay, write against this politician, write against this institute, write against this group. All this happens, you know. It happens more in the Muslim press. That you take this money and write against this organization, you take this money, write in favor of this organization. This type of journalism is haram. If it's a fact, you can very well say, sister, and we require journalists. It's part of dawah. It's a part of the duty of the Muslim Ummah to spread the message of Islam. Today is the age of journalism, technology, satellite, etc. You have to utilize this media to spread Islam, sister. Hope that answers the question.
Do we have any questions from the gents section?
Assalamu alaikum. I am Hashim Ali. Brother Jakir Naik, my question is, it was published in an article, I can't remember that magazine name, regarding Miraj of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It says, in the 6th century, a fool claimed that he went to heaven. How we the Muslim Ummah clear this type of misconception?
The brother asked me a question that he read an article that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to heaven. How can Muslim Ummah create such a misconception? Whether prophets have been given various miracles, and prophets can do miracles, they are signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are referring to the Mi'raj of beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The references are given in the Quran in Surah Isra, chapter 17, verse number 1, that the Prophet was transported from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. And then you read in the Sahih Hadith in Sahih Bukhari that the Prophet went to the heavens, etc. It's a fact. Thing is that these are miracles. Like the Quran says that Musa alayhi salam split the ocean into two, the sea into two. Isa alayhi salam, he was born without a male intervention. These are miracles. Neither can science disprove, neither can science confirm. That goes in the ambiguous slot. What we say, these were the prophets of God, they were messenger of God, they were given certain miracles. So these were done with the permission and will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers the question.
We have a brother by the name of Jose Matthew whose question is, why do Muslims call Islam as the best religion when there are many Muslims who are unreliable and dishonest? These Muslims are involved in activities such as frauds, bribing, cheating, or dealing in drugs. Can you please explain?
The question posed was that why do you call Islam as the best way of life when you find Muslims dealing in drugs, dealing in alcohol, cheating, etc.? Why Islam is the best? You can refer to my video cassette. I've given the talk, Islam, the Universal Religion, Islam, Introduction, and there I've proven that why Islam is the best way of life. For Islam not only speaks good things, it shows you a way how to achieve that good things. And if you heard in my talk, I always speak about Islam as the best way of life. The reason that you find that, you know, people saying Muslims are bad, they deal in alcohol, they deal in drugs, they deal in this. I do know that there are black sheep in every community. I do know Muslims, though Quran says alcohol is prohibited, some Muslim can drink the non-Muslim under the table. I do know that. The media is in the hands of the Western world. The media projects Islam in the wrong way. We do have black sheep in the community, even in Islam, even in Muslims we have black sheep. As I give the example, that if you find one Arab, age of 50, marrying a girl of 16 years old, it becomes a headline in the paper. You know, as though every day you find thousands of Arabs marrying 16 years old girls, as we're projecting it that way. And on the other hand, when you have a non-Muslim, 50 years old man, raping a 10 years old girl, it's nowhere there in the news. See, media is in their hand. So they influence the people to make Muslims look like terrorists, like fundamentalists, like bad people. They project it that way. So because media is in their hand, they give a wrong picture. I'm not saying that we don't have Muslims who are bad. Actually, a Muslim cannot be bad. Because Muslim means one who submits his will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he submits his will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not gamble, he will not rob, he will not have drugs, he will not rape, he will not molest. These Muslims, they're namesake Muslims. They're lip service Muslims. They're pseudo-Muslims. They aren't true Muslims. They are black sheep in our community. But in spite of this, alhamdulillah, yet, as a whole, Muslim as a whole, yet, alhamdulillah, with all the drawbacks that we have, yet, alhamdulillah, we are the biggest community of teetotalers. Teetotalers means we don't touch alcohol as a whole. We're the biggest community that gives maximum charity with all our drawbacks, alhamdulillah. We are the community which has the maximum modesty, maximum sobriety, alhamdulillah, with all the black sheep in our community. So firstly, I blame the media. And besides that, even if someone says that, okay, Muslims are bad. Suppose, hypothetically, I do agree that most of the Muslims are bad, hypothetically. But what I say, in my talk, I speak about Islam as the best way of life. I don't speak about Muslims as the best. And if suppose you want to judge a car, suppose you have a Mercedes car, and you want to analyze how good the car is. A person who does not know how to drive the car, he sits on the steering wheel and he bangs up the car. Who will you blame? Will you blame the car or the driver? Who will you blame? The driver. The driver did not know to drive the car. He didn't have a license, first time he's driving a car. Similarly, if there are Muslims who are not practicing Islam correctly, blame the Muslims, not the religion. If you want to judge the religion, judge according to authentic sources, the Quran and the Sahih Hadith. And if you want an exemplary Muslim, the best Muslim example is our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's no better example. If you want to judge a car, put the best driver and then judge it. The best person, best exemplary Muslim, as the Quran says in Surah Qalam, chapter 68, verse number 4, verily thou art standard on the highest standard of character. Quran says in Surah Azab, chapter 33, verse 21, that verily in the messenger you'll find the most beautiful pattern of conduct. The best example is the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's the best example. If you want to judge Islam, judge by his behavior. No wonder Michael H. Hart, a person who's an American, who's a Christian, who wrote a book on the 100 most influential people in history. The 100 most influential people in history, right from Adam, peace be upon him, till present time. And number one he gave, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He's not a Muslim. Why should he give Prophet Muhammad number one, peace be upon him? It's a fact. He was an honest person. And Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, number three. Number one is Muhammad, peace be upon him. Best exemplary. I do know people say, oh, you know, you're fine, that you find no Muslim country which is good, and there goes a bad thing, and this thing. I said, see, I do know that there's not a single country in the world who's following Islam in toto. But there are countries which follow certain parts. Those countries which follow criminal law, you find crime the least in that country. Those which follow the economic law, you find economics the best in that country. If you want to judge any community as a whole, a country or a state which are the best, at the time of the beloved Prophet, best example. At the time of the four rightly guided Khalifas, Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Usman, Hazrat Ali, may Allah be pleased with them all. Best example. See the community at that time. It was the best. If you want to judge as a state, by implementing Islamic law completely, what results come? See the times of the rightly guided Khalifa and the time of the beloved Prophet. That's the best. Hope that answers the question.
May we have the next question from the sister's side.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Naushin, from a school student from Mangalore.